Jose Marti Airport. This is the first visit by the General Secretary of the Soviet Communist Party to the first socialist country of America. Breshnev is warmly and sincerely welcomed by Fidel Castro Ruz, the first secretary of the Cuban Communist Party and the prime minister of the revolutionary government. This is a meeting between old and true friends. Leonid Brezhnev is warmly welcomed by President Osvaldo Dorticos Torrado, the second secretary of the Cuban Communist Party, first deputy prime minister and minister of the revolutionary armed forces, Raul Castro Ruz, and other Cuban officials. Leonid Brezhnev is accompanied by Politburo member of the Soviet Communist Party and Foreign Minister Andrei Gromyko, First Secretary of the Communist Party of Ukraine, Vladimir Sherbitsky, alternate Politburo member and First Secretary of the Leningrad Regional Party Committee, Grigory Romanov, Central Committee Secretary Konstantin Katashev, and other Soviet officials. Also in the welcoming party is Central Committee member and USSR Ambassador to Cuba, Nikita Tolubeyev. Speech was made by Fidel Castro.
Nuestro pueblo se reúne en gigantesca y entusiasta multitud para expresarle a usted.
Our people have come to this gigantic rally with great enthusiasm to express to you, Comrade Brezhnev, and the party and government leaders accompanying you, our feelings of friendship, love, and respect for the great Soviet people, for the heroic party, which, under the leadership of the immortal Lenin, carried out the first socialist revolution in the history of mankind. Fidel Castro spoke enthusiastically about the fraternal solidarity between the peoples of Cuba and the Soviet Union, about the significance of that solidarity for the heroic, selfless struggle by the Cuban people for independence, freedom, and social justice. In his speech at the meeting, Fidel Castro emphasized the great significance of the very existence of the Soviet Union for the world revolutionary process, its internationalist fraternal aid to the peoples struggling for national liberation and social progress. He stressed the exclusive importance of the peace program endorsed by the 24th Congress of the Soviet Communist Party. All the peoples in the world and the most far-sighted politicians, declared Fidel Castro, highly value the peace policy and the steadfast efforts of the USSR aimed at easing international tensions and stopping the arms race. The Communist Party and the people of Cuba give their resolute backing to the Soviet Union in this struggle and wish it further progress on this path for the well-being of mankind. The days of the visit were filled with heart-to-heart talks, business negotiations about the present and the future, and an exchange of opinions on a wide range of questions. They discussed the present state and prospects for developing bilateral fraternal ties between the Soviet Union and Cuba, the Soviet and Cuban Communist parties, problems of the contemporary international situation. The results of the talks were reflected in a joint Soviet-Cuban declaration signed by Leonid Brezhnev and Fidel Castro. This important political document sums up the experience of genuine international cooperation between the first socialist country in the world and the first socialist country in Latin America. It maps out a program for a further development of their ties, coordination of their efforts in the struggle to build up cohesion of the socialist community and the world communist movement. The declaration reaffirms the noble goals of the foreign policy of the countries in the socialist community, a policy aimed at deepening international detente and ensuring universal peace, establishing a system of collective security in Europe and other regions of the world, a policy aimed at resolutely repulsing imperialist aggression and supporting the people's struggle for national liberation and social progress, announcing their fidelity to the cause of strengthening universal peace on the basis of the principles of peaceful coexistence between states with different social systems. The Soviet Union and Cuba reaffirm their resolute will to work with other fraternal countries, with all progressive forces, for consolidating the positive changes in the international situation, giving it a stable and irreversible nature.